the sound, vocabulary that astounds. From the planet lexicon, watch her villains, here she comes. Faced with a catastrophe, we need the living dictionary. Her superior intellect keeps the crime world in check. Go, girl! Huggy faces by her side, vocabulary a mile wide. She'll make sure that crime will pay and throw some mighty words your way. Word up, it's Word Girl.
Listen for the words inquire and hilarious.
To an outsider, nighttime in the city can look a little scary. But you might be surprised to find out that behind their exteriors, these apartment buildings are filled with people just like you. Aspiring villains in their final class at villain school. Hey, they're not people just like you. What's going on in there?
I hold in my hands two official graduation certificates from the coach's school for evil villains and archenemies. Unfortunately, that means one of you didn't make the cut.
Oh, please have one for big left hand guy.
Invisibil! That's me! Invisibil!
So which one of us didn't make it?
Not so fast. I'd like to make this as long and overly dramatic as possible. Miss Question, will you please stand up? Congratulations. You are the first person to find out whether or not you earned your official graduation certificate. And the decision is, you did not fail to disappoint me.
Huh?
Which means you are not graduating, but Invisibel and Big Left Hand Guy are.
Woo! Whoopee!
Woo!
Hooray for me! Yay! Invisibil!
What? But haven't I completed all the assignments?
Well, yes.
So doesn't that mean I really did pass?
No, it does not.
Why? I mean, don't you like my name?
Miss Question's a world-class villain name. Love it.
And did you notice that my outfit has a tiny question mark stitching?
Yeah, this is uncomfortable. Oh, hello. You're missing the one thing every evil villain needs to take it to the next level.
And what's that?
A superpower. Take Big Left Hand Guy. He's got that big left hand. Isn't that something?
Hey, thanks, Coach.
And check out Invisibil. He can make himself invisible.
Bye-bye. Hello.
And his name is Bill, which is just perfect. Which brings me to you.
What about me?
You call yourself Miss Question. And you certainly do. Ask a lot of questions.
And you don't think that's a superpower?
No. It's just kind of annoying.
But what about my question mark lassos? Aren't they super?
That's not a superpower either. It's more of a sewing thing. Listen, Miss Q, it's never easy to cut anyone from the team, but you just don't have what it takes.
How can this night get any worse?
Don't worry, kids. That's not dangerous lightning. It's just strong enough to cause superpowers.
Hey, would you mind keeping your inquiring down a little? The new graduates and I are trying to enjoy our celebration cake.
Do you notice anything different about me, Coach?
No.
Are you sure?
Yep.
Do you want to rethink that?
Well, maybe, but... Right. More of the annoying questions. Well,
Coach, tell me, what do you think of this?
Who am I? What am I doing here?
Why? Huh? What?
How do you like my new ability to make people question everything, even who they are? Would you call that a superpower? Who can stop me now?
How'd I get cake on my mustache?
The next morning at the Botsfords, TJ entertains his family with a joke book he borrowed from the public library.
Ooh, gum jokes. This is a good one. What did the piece of gum say to the shoe?
I've heard this one.
I'm stuck on you.
Shoo! I get it. That's terrific.
Hilarious, right? Okay, who wants to hear another one?
Well, I'm not sure we have
time. Me. I do.
What do cats read in the morning?
What do cats read in the morning? Fine, you know this.
Paper or plastic? Which one is better for stealing all the money in the register? Someone's robbing the grocery store. We have to stop her.
Let's review the setup, shall we? What do cats read in the morning? Nobody? Give up? Newspapers!
That's hilarious, DJ.
I just remembered I have to
so
go
funny.
To school early. Would anyone like to inquire why?
I can't even.
No. That money doesn't go there. If you're inquiring about a job here, you can't be messing up important things like where the money goes.
Why do you think I want to work here?
Well, you can't. Not anymore.
Can't you see I'm stealing all your money?
Aha! Taking from the till, are you? You're fired.
How can you fire me from robbing you?
Good point. After examining the facts, I can tell you're a creative thinker. Congratulations, you're back on the team.
How about I just... Hold me there! Put down that money and... Did she pay for the food?
I don't think she did.
And the food, too! Word girl, have you ever wondered why you dress up and fight crime? Not really, no. And isn't it a little strange that your best friend is a tortoise? Monkey, actually, and it's not strange at all. He's the best. Aw, have you known each other a long time? Let's see, 2, 3. Should I just go ahead and go now? Oh, yeah, sure. I mean, no! Ugh, no more questions, Ms. Question. You're coming with me. Oh, am I? Am I really? Who are you? Who am I? Word up? Am I good or what?
Wow, you really botched that one up, Word Girl. I'm afraid I can't let you work here.
Later, as TJ entertains his growing number of fans, Becky is in no mood for jokes.
Your laughter is like medicine to me. Is this your first time as a crowd before? So, how about that gingerbread man, folks? Can't catch me on the... Right. What's the deal with that guy?
What is his deal?
Does he ever step in gum?
Well, not now, Bob. I'm trying to figure out a way to defeat Ms. Question. Plus, I know all these jokes. I took that joke book out in second grade.
Save it for the end, people.
Hilarious? No, I don't think those jokes are hilarious. I mean, they're funny, but hilarious means really, really, really funny, and I just don't think...
This guy is really, really, really funny!
Well, there you go. I just wish I knew where Ms. Question was going to strike next. This is much better than the other thing we were gonna do today. Go to the museum to see the new question mark of Socrates on display.
Oh yeah, that's the pin that Socrates wore in ancient Greece, right?
That's the one, at the museum. But why are we talking about it? Let's keep listening to this hilarious comedy show. Who cares about some incredibly valuable question mark, am I right? You know who would care about that? No, I'm not telling a joke, I'm really asking. The answer is Ms. Question, that's who. But we still need a plan. I have an idea, Bob. Word up! Is stealing the pin gonna be this easy? Who's gonna try and stop me?
The museum is now closed. If you'd like to inquire about that artifact, you can come back during regular hours, young lady.
Why can't I see it now?
That's just not the way we do things here at the museum.
Isn't the point of a museum to show people things?
Of course, but...
So why does it close?
Why does it close? That's a good question.
And who's to say I can't take the question mark of Socrates home with me? Does it belong to Socrates? To the museum? Does anyone really own anything?
These are tough questions. I will have to inquire with my supervisor.
Why do people keep saying that word, inquire, around me? What does it even mean? I'll answer that question! Word girl? To inquire is to look for information or to ask questions. You inquire a lot. In fact, if you wanted, you could change your name to Miss Inquire! Is that supposed to be funny? Yeah.
Word girl, this nice young woman was just inquiring about our newest piece.
Oh, she wasn't just inquiring. Ms. Question wants more than information. She wants to take the question mark of Socrates, but she can't have it. Don't
don't you remember what happened the last time we did this?
Just one second, Ms. Question. First, I have a question for you.
Oh, what is it?
What time is it when an elephant sits on your fence?
What time when an elephant? Hey, what are you...
Time to get a new fence!
Oh, that's an oldie but a goodie. I love it.
And speaking of time, why did the girl throw a clock out the window?
Why did she do that? What am I missing here?
She wanted to see time fly!
Who knew Word Girl was so hilarious?
And now it's time for me to fly!
Do you really want to mess with me?
Now, there'll be no horseplay, girls.
Will Word Girl forget who she is once again? Will Ms. Question get her hands on the question mark of Socrates? Oh, wait a minute. This question thing is kind of annoying.
Why is everybody in such a hurry all the time? I mean, what's the rush? When's my snack break?
Why do I ask so many questions? Who am I? Is this poetic justice?
It sure is.
Where are you taking me? Do you know who I am? Should I call the police? Is there anybody listening?
Still asking questions, huh?
And so, Ms. Question is left to inquire how her plan to steal the question mark of Socrates was foiled. And she'll have plenty of time to find answers in jail. Hey, Word Girl, if she wants her time there to fly by, maybe she should try throwing a clock out the window, right? Come on. That was hilarious. Join us next time for another colossal, exciting adventure of Word Girl.
Hello, I'm Beau Handsome, and this is...
May I have a word?
As usual, the player who correctly defines today's featured word will win a fabulous prize. Let's play!
May I have a word?
Yes, you may. Today's featured word is silhouette. To give you a clue, here are some clips from Word Girl that show the meaning of the word. Tommy!
The one thing all those clips have in common is Word Girl, and she's a superhero. She's a superhero. So, obviously, silhouette is another word for a superhero.
Sorry, that is incorrect. Anyone else? Phil!
Is it a regular superhero?
Sorry, that too is incorrect. Emily!
Based on the clips, I think it's the outline of someone or something that appears all black.
That is correct, Emily. Congratulations, you are today's winner. Huggy, show her what she's won. It's an official Word Girl movie screen. Project movies on it and have your very own home theater. Or just make funny silhouettes. That's it for today's episode. See you next time on...
May I Have a Word?
Kids, today's featured words are disorderly and famished. Another beautiful day at school. Becky Botsford and her classmates are gathered for an assembly, and there's an air of excitement in the, air.
Everybody settle down, please. Bob, acrobatic tricks at school assembly are disorderly. Please take your seat. That hairy kid should be on the Olympic team. Now, as you know, we're here today to honor our beloved lunch lady, Miss O'Brien, who's retiring after 80 years... 80 years? Yes, 80 years of loyal service. So let's hear it for Miss O'Brien.
Thank you. Children, I've enjoyed preparing lunch for you and your parents and your grandparents and your great-grandparents and your great... great-grandparents. So now, as I pass the spatula to the next lunch lady, let me remind you, no matter how famished you may be, don't be disorderly in the lunch line. And most importantly, don't ask me what's in the fish sticks. Believe me, you don't want to know. Peace!
Well, my, that was exciting. but not nearly as exciting as our next special guest, our city's district attorney, Mrs. Botsford.
Hello, kids. I'm District Attorney Botsford, Becky Botsford's mom. Hi, Becky.
Hi, Mom.
No. As district attorney, I'm responsible for making sure villains who've committed crimes go to jail. But I've also got a new plan to help criminals return to a law-abiding life by getting honest jobs. So without further ado, allow me to introduce your new lunch lady.
I prefer lunch fellow.
Chuck, the evil sandwich-making guy.
Oh, this is going to be a disaster. How many times have we arrested him? Oh, this day can't get any worse.
Oh, and Becky, you left something at home.
The next day, Becky and her classmates line up for lunch. Whoa, that looks delicious.
Yikes, I'm famished. Peanut butter and jelly, don't mind if I do. Though, I still don't trust Chuck. We'd better keep a close eye on him.
May I help you?
Can I get a ham and cheese?
A ham and cheese? I'll give you a ham and cheese. Here you go.
Thanks.
Oh, it's a pleasure to serve you. Come again soon.
Huh, that was unexpected. May I have a peanut butter and jelly?
You betcha. Voila. How about your little aardvark there? He looks famished. Wow, you really love my sandwiches. This is the best job ever. And for once in my life, I just know tomorrow's gonna be even better than today.
Mr. Lunch Lady, Lunch Fellow, your sandwiches make lunch my favorite class of the day.
Oh, I'm blushing.
Hello, Chuck. Chuck, I just want to say you're doing a great job.
You know, maybe Mom was right about Chuck. Maybe all he needed was another chance.
There is, however, one thing I'm concerned about.
That kids will go home and toss their dinners in the trash because they can't hold a candle to my sandwiches?
Yes, but also you need to wear a hairnet.
No, that's okay. I'm very clean. I shower twice a day, and I take a bath every night.
I'm sure you do. But the law requires that everyone who works in the school food preparation industry wear a hairnet. So here.
Ow, 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 ow! It's a kind of pinches!
Oh, Chuck, get a hold of yourself. There's no need to be so disorderly.
It's too uncomfortable. Then I won't wear it.
I'm sorry to hear that.
I'm sorry you're sorry to hear that.
Well, I'm sorry that you... Look, either wear a hairnet or you can't work here.
Oh, really? In that case, I quit. Ha! Lunch lady, lunch fellow, out! You guys blew it. Best lunch person ever. I'm done here.
A little later, Chuck lets the Crusher tell everyone what he thinks about the hairnet rule.
This is exactly why we did all those drills, children. Line up and file out calmly. When the alarm sounds, there must be no disorderly conduct.
What's that, Bob? Someone's playing Foursquare without observing World Playground Game Association rules? Huh, we'd better check it out.
Oh, that's what you think. This baby's on a timer, and I'm the only one who knows the secret password to shut it off.
Ugh, fine. What are your demands?
I want a hairnet that doesn't make my hair hurt.
I don't think it's possible for hair to hurt.
Well, what do you know? You're just a voice. You could be bald for all I know.
I'm assuming you've already tried the Hairnet Emporium, Hairnet World, and Hairnets Ahoy, right?
No. I didn't even think to check the Hairnet District.
Why must you torture me?
Now that's luxurious. How does it look?
Super.
Really? Wow. My mom always said I was handsome.
Great. You got your hairnet. Now disable the Crusher, please.
No problem. Let me just type in this secret password. Chuck? No. Evil? No. Sandwich? No. Making? No. Guy? Well, that's all I got.
Are you serious? How could you forget the password?
I don't know. I thought of it earlier today when I was at home. Was it on the bus? Maybe I was home.
Look, just stay here and keep trying to think of the password. Huggy and I will retrace your steps and look for clues.
Charles, is that you?
Charles? That could be the password.
Charles, I'm talking to you! I'm famished! You were supposed to make me a sandwich, then watch my stories with me! Hello? Chuckleberry?
Chuckleberry? That's gotta be it. Out of the way, Charles! Or should I say, Chuckleberry?
Hey, that's my mom's special nickname for me.
But is it the password? Let's see, Chuckleberry. No, Charles? Does your mom have any other pet names for you?
No, not that I could think of.
Oh, come on, Huggy. We better keep trying to figure out that password.
Oh, all right. You want an old-fashioned bus versus superhero drag race? Because you got it. Here we go, baby!
No, I don't want to race. I need to get on the bus.
Do you have exact change?
Look, if you don't let me on, an entire school is going to get crushed by a giant sandwich press.
I need exact change. Everyone settle down. Quit being so disorderly.
Do you know what disorderly means?
Yes.
It means rowdy and out of control. And no one on this bus is being rowdy or out of control.
That lady back there was, moving her lips too fast while she was reading to herself.
Right. Listen, did you have a passenger earlier today with a sandwich for a head?
Look, lady, I got a lot of passengers who fit that description.
Sandwich enthusiast. That's gotta be Chuck's magazine. Maybe the password for the crusher's in there. Let's go! Word up!
My magazine! And I must have forgot it on the bus.
All right, let's see. Enthusiast, contents, recipe.
Oh, no!
Oh, we're running out of time. Think, Chuck. Chuck!
Oh, the crusher. Right.
Keep looking for clues, will ya? Huggy, what are you doing? What do you mean you're famished? Famished means extremely hungry. I should know by now you're always famished. What are you doing? There's less than a minute left. Why aren't you trying to figure out the password?
Did you know Bologna is named after a place in Italy? Man, I gotta visit the... I know. The password is password.
Are you kidding me?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yay! I did it! I'm a hero.
A hero?
Hello up there.
Word girl, would you grab Chuck for a second? I think there may be a better place to use his talents.
Gladly.
Two brains, party of one. Hey, Cookie, what's the special today? I'm famished.
Here you go.
Grilled cheese, my favorite. Oh, and a toothpick. Talk about classy.
And so, once again, Word Girl and Captain Huggy Face save the day. Gee, I'm famished from all this narrating. That's good. Anyway, we'll see you soon, loyal viewers. In the meantime, try not to do anything disorderly while patiently awaiting the next thrilling episode of Word Girl!
Word Girl!
Hello, I'm Beau Handsome, and this is the bonus round of...
May I have a word?
our returning champion will have a chance to play for even greater prizes on the bonus round. Emily, you correctly defined the word silhouette. Ready to play the bonus round?
Sure am, Mr. Handsome.
Great. Take a look at these three pictures and tell me which one shows the definition for silhouette. What's your answer, Emily?
I can only see the outline or silhouette of Dr. Two Brains. Number one.
That's correct, which means you're our bonus round winner. Show her what she's won, Huggy. Your very own parade. See you next time on
May I Have a Word?